Coach Mike, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Yeah. You're the coordinator for West Africa, Giant of Africa.
Oh, yes,
right,
I
here
am.
In Ghana. It's year 15 for Giant of Africa. Take us through the journey in your own words, in your own eyes, how it has been from the get-go up until this point.
It has been an amazing journey so far. We started back in 2003 in Zaria, and today we've been able to go to 10 different countries in Africa. So it has been an amazing journey.
10 countries. Was that part of the plan initially? Because I know you and Masai and Godwin, you all grew up together, and you were right there when you guys began to think about it. Was it ever in the plan to, you know, go this big?
Oh yes. It's always been part of our dreams to do something big with basketball. Of course, back then we didn't realize or know it could become this big, but we've always had the dream to do something big in basketball.
You're a coach in the developmental scene, you know, even in Nigeria. For you, what's the motivation behind, you know, staying true to that aspect of the game?
I believe personally that's the most important part of coaching. Simply because that is where you teach the basic fundamentals of the game. Because at the senior level, you're really not coaching. All you're doing is managing egos, managing characters. But at this level, where the children are still developing in character, they're still developing emotionally and physically, is the best time to instill the right character and teach them the basic fundamentals correctly. And so when they become senior players, it becomes easier for them to play the game.
This year you've toured a few countries, coming to Ghana right now. And how impressed are you about, you know, what you've seen and experienced so far?
Ghana has been very interesting, especially for this year. Golden Star Resources have done a tremendous job in providing us with funds and the partnership to do this year's camp. And as you can see, they put up this facility, which for me is a fantastic facility, and I hope the people in this community will make the most use of it, especially for the youth here, to develop the game of basketball in Ghana.
You coordinate West Africa, now we're in Ghana. Any other countries in the horizon soonest?
Yes, we've done Côte d'Ivoire along the coast of West Africa. We've done Ghana. We are looking at going into Benin Republic. But I'm sure, like you know, our camps involve a lot of logistics. And so we'll have to have the right logistics in place, the right people, the right facilities before we make a move. So there's definitely plans to go to other West African countries. And don't forget, most West African countries are French speaking. So that is a little logistic we'll have to sort out before we can move to some of these countries.
Looking at the journey, what would you say, or what would you point out as the major challenges you guys have faced, you know, time and time over, you know, as you guys have done these camps over the years, even in Nigeria, you know, and then all these countries you have been to?
The basic challenge for us is logistics, traveling, moving our equipment, moving our personnel around. Because we bring in coaches from the US and Canada, and sometimes from around Africa. So the biggest challenge has always been that of traveling, you know, connecting the flights, and then also the time difference. Because coaches coming from America, they're flying into the future. And sometimes we have coaches coming from East Africa who are flying back into time. And so that has really been our main challenge, you know. So other than that, it's always been fun traveling around and doing our camps in Africa.
as a scout, how we deal with the level of talent in Africa, what are the things you think, we need to start doing now that we can get to that elite level in a rapid succession?
Without a doubt, Africa has unbelievable talent. The talent is unreal. And unfortunately, we've not been able to harness this talent and develop it to the optimal level. But talking about what we need to do, we need to develop more facilities. We need to develop more infrastructure, because that is where it starts from. I mean, you see these kids playing, if we didn't have a basketball court here, they'll be somewhere else doing something else. So if we have a facility, that's the first point. And then we also need to develop coaches, especially at this lower level. We need to develop our administrators, those who administer the game, and not just the game of basketball, sports as a whole. Because you find that in Africa, for most of the countries in Africa, sports is like an afterthought. We need to bring sports back to the front burner, because sports to me is as important as education. And once we do that, it's a matter of time, everything we need will fall into place.
Yeah, you just talked about coaching, and I got wind of the fact that you're putting together a coach training program. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Yes, I've been doing that for the past 1.5 years now, where we train coaches, but not in the practical aspect of the game, but in the emotional and the psychological aspect. Why do I say that? Because we have a lot of coaches who are very good technically. They can coach the game, but they don't have the right character. They don't have the psychological and emotional balance to coach the game. And by that I mean, you have a lot of coaches who, if I may use that word, who are cheap. All they want to do is take advantage of the young children they are coaching, either by depriving them, you know, equipment, sometimes even money. And for the female players, you have coaches who are taking advantage of female players by harassing them sexually. And those are the areas I strongly believe we need to address. Because it's no use for a coach to be very good technically and tactically, and then he's not a good person, he's not honest. Because whatever profession you find yourself, if you are not honest, you are not going to succeed. So that's the reason I'm doing that program, to educate and enlighten more coaches to understand that this game can be better than it is now if we have more people who are honest and true to the game.
And also I came to understand, or I have come to understand rather, you know, that education is also a key part, you know, of what Giants of Africa is doing, not just, you know, teaching, you know, the skills of basketball. Why do you guys think that is so much important as much as it is, you know, training and sports itself?
Education is so important because our children spend more time in school than they do at home during the course of the year. For instance, in Nigeria, the school calendar is about 6 to 8 months. So for most of the year, the children are in school. And so it's easier for us to go to the schools where we will readily find the children and begin to teach them basketball than it is for us to go to the streets. Even though in many parts of Africa you find so many children in the streets. But the reason why we want to go to the school is because the school is an organized, formal setup where there's rules and regulations. In the streets, there are no rules. It's survival of the fittest. But in the schools, there's a formal and structured, regimented way of doing things, where knowledge is imparted to the children. And so it's much easier under that platform for us to do basketball. For us, that's the bottom line. Because if you are doing it because of what you stand to gain and not what you want to give, then it's a matter of time you will fall by the wayside. You're welcome.